Nightmare Gizmo here. I know it's been a while since we've talked about the boat, but you know, I had to get through winter time, and my shop here isn't really, you know, not very warm, and so we had to hold up on some of the repairs. But now we've had some pretty good weather, and I've gotten back on the boat here, and I've had some people ask, and what was I doing, or where was I at on the boat itself? So I decided to, on this good week right here we're having, to go ahead and do some more repairs and update everybody where I'm at. So what we're doing here is we're making a repair to the floor. Really, this is the only real problem with the whole boat. You know, it's in really good shape, actually, other than it had to do a little bit of wet sanding to all of the gel coat and all that kind of stuff. Anyway, I just want to talk about my floor here. And, you know, I don't know if I'm right. I don't know if I'm wrong. I'm only going by what I think that might work. At first, I was just going to go ahead and put down this plywood, you know, 3/4 inch plywood. And the problem I have is, and maybe a lot of the boats, if you look right here, from right here back up to here, there's like a V. So the boat itself has a real natural V to it, so all of the water can drain. So I went and laid down my 3/4 inch plywood, and guess what? It creates a gap right underneath of it. So I was a kind of, and also when I got up on there, I'm not very light. When I got up on there, it felt like I was on a dang diving board. So what I went on ahead and did was, I did this because I'm thinking that if I make it like a trough, in other words, if any water was to get inside of here, no matter what, it has some place to go. Trash and water and whatever, leaves or whatever, still has some place to go, you know, to still drain out. Typically, this is not really in my possession. This won't be an outside boat. This will be kept in a garage, so I'm not worried about debris and tree limbs and so forth. So while it's in my possession, it will always be in the garage. So I thought about doing it this way to make out this trough system to see if it would, you know, help me as far as the floor goes and all that. So anyway, I'm going to show you where I'm at. Put my floor in. So we're having some pretty good weather out here right now. We've had a pretty good downpour, almost 7 to 8 inches, kind of west of us. Put the other piece right here. And of course, got the last one right here. I do some of these videos is so to help other people that may have some of the same problems or run into the same problems that I might have. Well, guess what? I ran into a problem. Even though as much as I did on this floor, I think it's going to turn out pretty good. You know, when I put my trough in there, you saw all those screws? That's just to help all that stay down. You know, so this part right here, when I go screw it down, it don't move. Hey, guess what, guys? You're all gonna get a kick out of this. When you put your screws in, make sure that you don't screw through the bottom of the dang boat. Anyway, be sure that all your screws at some type of 45 degree angle in both directions. And of course, make sure you're not so dang close to the edge of the dang boat. But anyway, I'm a human. I make mistakes. That's all right. So I just wanted to give a little update for everybody out there where I'm at on this floor. And I'll have some more videos coming up. As you can see, also I'm going to have a video for, I ripped out the cluster that, not needed. I will have a more updated system. Those were all glass type fuses. Let me go back over here. Those were glass type fuses. And what we're going to put in is what we call a... What we're going to put in is a... let me get it out here. This is where you put in a spade type fuses. That's where the main positive goes on. And then you put your spade and your power going out. There's power coming in, coming this side, goes over, comes down, and then goes out to wherever you need it to power up. And to get rid of those glass type fuses that, you know, if you're out, doing your thing and everything, that, that there should be a problem, at least with updated fuses, at least you can, you know, get those anywhere. Shoot, you might even have a spare one inside of your truck for in the extra fuse department, but at least you won't have to worry about no glass fuse where, you know, people were living back in the 60s on that part. But anyway, this is Nightmare Gizmo. Just want to talk about the ProCraft bass boat I'm redoing, and got some pretty neat stuff coming up for everybody. And anyway, it's Nightmare Gizmo. We're gone.